Yo, what's up everybody? It's here comes that from Brotherhood Gaming, back at it with another video. And today's video, we gotta do something called how to prepare yourself for 2K20. As you guys can see, we had a lot of 2K20 news that's been dropping, clothing wise, player wise, how the new neighborhood will look like, things like that. You guys know a lot of things that's happening that I don't really need to explain, but I just want to, you know, help you guys like a survival guide on how to, you know, prepare yourself for 2K20, things you should do and things you shouldn't be doing. All right, so let's get right into this video. If you guys can just please like and subscribe, that would be nice, and especially share this video out, that would be even better. All right, let's get right into it. What you guys really need to know is the fact that my career is going to be perfect for you. You all need to play my career. I know you all want to get eager to, I know you all are so eager to play Park. I know we all are. Everybody wants to play Park. But what is Park if your character isn't ready for it? 2K19, we've seen a lot of characters coming into the park. Even when it was like a few weeks in or months in, with like 60 overalls, 70 overalls, or just high like overalls but with no badges. Like that's not a good thing. That's not a good thing. What you need to try to do as soon as 2K drop or when it's pre-loot drop, take advantage of first testing the build that you want. And then when you find that right build, you play the entire time on 2K20 using my career. I'm not saying don't go out and play Park. If you want to do that, fine. But spend your time mostly in the my career trying to grind out badges, trying to get up on a lot of VC, you know, do all of that stuff first. You want to handle those first. Like, have your priorities set. Because when 2K20 drop, I think most of us know what we're going to do. So next time, When you see this, take advantage of this. Take advantage of what I'm telling you or what others might tell you. Take advantage of my career, because that's going to be the thing that you're going to need to improve your character. Of course, faster than any other game mode they will have out. But this will be it. This will be faster to get your 99 or get all the badges that you want. There's something seriously wrong with this girl, bro. Hey guys, another part of this video, we're going to talk about VC. So, the reason why I'm using the stage for an example for VC is because this is a place where you can earn even tons of VC while playing the park, and you could lose some along the way, and that's the negative part about this. What I want to tell you guys about your VC is that you need to save your VC up. I wouldn't expect you guys to be in this place, you know. If you guys want to be here, that's fine. Like I said, even whatever I say in this video is up to y'all if you want to listen. But what I'm trying to tell you guys, you need to save your VC in the start of 2K. You know, you don't need to be spending it on clothes and shit. You don't need to be spending it on things you really don't need. I saw people buying like bikes and shit, and you can only use the bike like to just ride it around the neighborhood. You can't even ride it through the park and all that. So what I'm trying to say is like, make sure when you get your VC, you save it up. You save it up so you can use it to buy yourself boost. Go to the Gatorade facility and buy something from there. You know, use it for more useful things. Don't use it for clothing. Don't use it for shoes. Don't use it for accessories to make yourself look cool. I'm not even trying to, you know, say that you can't do that. Go ahead if you want. That's fine. But I'm just saying, if you really want to save your VC wisely, you would want to save it up to a certain extent, like have a budget. For me, my VC, I grind it up to like 100,000, and I try to make sure I keep over 100,000. If I was to spend it, I want to spend at least to have it close to 100,000. Even if it was under like 95,000, that's fine. But I try to have it above that or over 100,000. You feel me? I don't try to spend under that. I don't try to spend over that. Like I try to keep it within the range I want it to be. So save up on your VC. Don't come to the stage yet, especially because like you have people like him that's trying to come to the stage. And he loses his VC. You have people like him who comes to the stage with his overall and rank. Look at his park rep. Look at that. Amateur 1. Guys like me will take advantage of this and try to play you just to steal your VC. No matter if it's 500, no matter if it's 1,000, they will come and try to take your VC. You want to avoid things like that, okay? thing I need to understand is the rec center. That's another thing. With the rec center, it's like playing park, but and pro-am, but a group of five versus another team of five. With this being said, if I was you guys, if you want to have a good rec center, because I've seen a lot of people. A lot of people had terrible rec records. So if you want to have a good rec record, you should play with your friends. Or if you don't play with your friends, try to avoid playing with players like you see here. You want to avoid this. You don't want to play with people like this, you know? Like, sometimes, even with the rec, the another reason why you don't want to play with, you know, with just randoms, because I don't know why in 2K19 they give you straight guards. Right now you don't see it, but if I had gotten the video from before, you guys would have saw it yourself. It'll be like four guards and one big man. So I mean, it's kind of difficult to even do this, you know. Sometimes you see these amateur ones, they consistently sell or do dumb shit. That's what hurts the whole game. Once they start doing like one or two bad plays, that's when the other team has the opportunity to take over, and you want to avoid things like that. You don't want to play with people that want to stack and sell you, and which would be randoms. And even when you turn on your mic to try and tell them to stop doing what they're doing, they do it just to piss you off, or because they already lost the game, a game that you guys can already come back. The game would be, y'all would be down five, and they keep hurt like selling the bag. You don't want to play with people like that. Play with your friends, or at least play with people that's not ass with terrible records. At least have a decent record, you know. Even if you're an amateur one, at least have a decent record, so I can tell that, oh, you're not that bad. You're probably like, you know, you probably had your bad games, or other people probably have sold you, and so you was in the same predicament as I. So yeah. But yeah, one thing y'all need to know about the park is this players. So let me tell you something. Let me use this for example. So let's say you see someone like this. That's what you don't do. It's him. Two amateurs and one elite. You don't want to do this. Unless you plan on just carrying them, you don't want to have them in your lineup. You don't. You see, he stepped off, because that's the smart thing he's supposed to do. Now let me step on, because I'm going to show y'all what I'm talking about. You don't want to play with players like this because of the fact that they sell and they come with bad builds. Like, the guy in the middle should have known that he should not be playing with the guy on the left, because he's too small compared to people on that team who look tough. So what I'm not supposed to do, let's say I was here before them and they stepped on the court with me. This is not supposed to happen. I'm not supposed to be playing with these two. I'm supposed to be stepping off. You're always supposed to pay attention. You're supposed to be aware of your surroundings. You avoid amateur ones. I don't know what they're going to do in the next 2K. I don't know if they're going to have amateur ones or whatever you're going to call them. But you can't come and play these type of people and have a team like the team as mine. Okay? That doesn't work. It will not work. It just won't. Look. Take a look for yourself. Look at the records. Look at the builds. Look at the positions. Does not make any sense. And yet they do it anyways. Thank you guys once more for watching this video. If this was very helpful, please leave a like and subscribe on this video. Also, accept notifications when you subscribe, and comment below if you have any video ideas or suggestions for this video. If you have a suggestion that we could do something better for when 2K21 comes out. So yeah. But anyways, thank y'all for watching. From one brother to another, peace.